In this WordPress Page Builder tutorial, I'm going to show you how to get started using Elementor. So let's jump right on in. So here I am logged into WordPress and I do not have Elementor installed just yet. To get Elementor is super easy. Just go to Plugins, click on Add New, and then you could do a simple search for Elementor. Elementor will pull right up. Just click on Install Now. Now that it's installed, go ahead and click on Activate to activate Elementor on your website. Now, before we jump into Elementor, I just want you to know that Elementor is compatible with every WordPress theme. However, there are certain WordPress themes that have better specific integration for it. So I'm going to go to Appearance and then Themes and share with you four different themes that are specifically made to accommodate Elementor. However, whichever WordPress theme you are using, I'm sure Elementor will work fine. But here are the top four themes for Elementor. There's the Astra theme, the GeneratePress theme, Ocean WP, and Page Builder Framework theme. And those are in alphabetical order. I'm going to go ahead and activate the first one, which is Astra. Now that Astra is activated, let's go ahead and take a look at the settings panel for Elementor by clicking on Elementor in the menu here. When you first click into Elementor, it takes you straight to the template area. One of the power features of Elementor is that you can save things so that you can reuse them. You can save entire pages and you can save sections of pages for easy reuse in all of the different pages on your website. For the Elementor settings, we'll go ahead and click on Settings right here. And this is going to provide some settings with how Elementor will work on your website. Next, we have a Role Manager. This is very good if you are making websites for people or you're going to have people logging into your website and you want to control what they can and cannot do with Elementor. Next, we have the Tools panel. And this is where you have some options here, one of them being Version Control. If you ever wanted to beta test a future version of Elementor, this is where you would enable it. Or if you wanted to roll back to a prior version, this is how you would do it. And we also have maintenance mode. This is a very nice feature that allows you to use Elementor to create a under construction or a coming soon page that will show when someone visits your website if it's not ready just yet. Lastly, we have a helpful link right here that says knowledge base. This will take you over to Elementor's website for any how-to articles that they might have there that interest you. So now that we've gone through the settings in the back end of Elementor, let's go ahead and create our first page using Elementor. I'm going to go to Pages, click on Add New, and I will name this Elementor. Next, I'll click on Publish to publish this page, and then I'll click on the button here that it says Edit with Elementor. This will open up Elementor, and we now are in the Elementor interface, and we can begin assembling the content on our page. But before we do that, I want to show you a couple helpful settings in the back end of Elementor. In the basic Elementor interface, right here we have a hamburger icon, and when we click on this, it will take us to some of the specific Elementor settings. Right now, we're looking at the view that shows us all of the useful modules that we can use when assembling our page. If we ever want to get back to this, we can click on the dial pad icon right here. Down on this bottom row, we have several other icons that we'll go over in a moment, and we also on some areas we have tabs here. So you see where it says elements and then we have global. And with a growing list of useful widgets, there's a search option here to quickly get to the widget that you want to use on your page. And let's not forget, we can make this panel completely disappear when we're previewing our page by clicking right here, and we get a full preview of what the page looks like. So now let's take a look at some of those settings by clicking on the hamburger icon in the top left. So first is default colors, and this is where we can choose default colors that Elementor modules will use when you are starting to drag and drop those on your page. So we have primary, secondary, text, and accent. and you can set these colors to whatever you want by clicking on it and choosing the color that you want or putting in a color code. Also, there are several different color palettes here that you can use if you prefer them. I'm going to go back into the settings panel by clicking on the hamburger icon. You can also set default fonts. So these would be your headline font, your secondary headline font, body text, and accent text. You can click on any of these and set what you want those fonts and the font weight to be. I'll go back to settings, and we also have an option to change the color picker colors. So everything you use in Elementor, when you're selecting a color, there's a color picker on the bottom with 8 color slots. This is where you would set what you want those color slots to be. And we'll go back to the Elementor settings. Next, we have this global settings option right here, where we can set some default generic fonts for our Elementor pages, also the width of the content area of our page, and also some various spacing items. Let's go back into our settings. If you click right here, it's going to take you back into the WordPress dashboard. And when you are done in a page, you can click this button here that says Exit to Dashboard. So I'll get back to the modules by clicking on the dial pad right here. Now let's go over some of our settings that we have down here on the bottom. First, we have the settings, and when you click on this, these are mostly the page settings. So you saw a moment ago how I created a page and named it Elementor. Well, this is where you could change that if you wanted, and you saw that I published this page. This is where you can change it to draft or something other. You can set a featured image for this piece of content, and if you wanted to start your page with a fresh slate, when you click on advanced, you can click this delete button here, and it will delete out all of the content on this page. Next, you can click on this style icon right here, and this is where you could set a background color or a background gradient color. You can manipulate some of the padding and spacing, and also for pro users, you can add custom CSS. Let's go ahead and get back to our module list. Next, we have this icon here, which is responsive mode. One of the power features of Elementor is you can see exactly how your page is going to look like on a desktop, on a tablet, or on a mobile device, and you can make settings to the way it looks so you can get your designs pixel perfect on every device. Next, we have this history option right here, where every change you make to your page will be recorded so that you can easily go back in time. Also, if you want to go back to a previous save, there's a revisions tab right here where you can go back in time to any prior time that you clicked on the save button. You can go here and go right back in time. Next, we have this eye right here, which is to preview the page that you are building. So when you click on this, your page is going to open up in a new tab outside of the Elementor interface and give you a chance to view the page to see how it's going to look to your website visitors. And lastly, we have this update or save button right here, and it will turn green whenever there is some content that needs to be saved. So now that we've gone over those basics, let's start building a page out. So when you first jump into Elementor and your page is blanked, you have these two options. One of them is to add a new section, and the next one is to add a new template. Now, the way that every web page that you go to and visit, they're all structured the same. It's simply a series of sections, and a section will have columns in it, and those columns will have elements like text or images or videos. That is all any web page actually is. In a section, you can set different background types. It could be a background color, a background gradient, a background image, or a background video, and we can do all of those things very easily with Elementor. So first, you would click on Add New Section, and you can choose, do you want that section to just be one block, or do you want it to be two columns or three columns or any of these various column layouts? Now, don't worry. You can easily adjust the size or the width of each of the columns in your sections. So first, I'm going to choose this one right here. So now when I hover my mouse here, you can see this blue bar, and that will take me to the settings for this particular section. So I can click right here where it says Edit Section, and then I have all of my section settings. So remember a moment ago, I said in your section, you can have colors and images and videos. Those are going to be in the style options right here. And so for background type, I can click right here where it says Classic, and then right here, I can choose a color. And here are those color picker colors that I talked about a moment ago. So if I wanted this color to be the background color, simply clicking on that color will change the background to that color. You have the option for gradients. You also have the option for background videos. Now, each of the modules, sections, and columns, they're typically going to have these three tabs up here at the top. Layout, or if you're editing a module, it will say content, style, and advanced. So now that we have our section set up, let's go ahead and put two columns in it. So I'm going to click on the dial pad, and here's a columns option right here. I can drag and drop it right there, and now I have these two columns, but they don't have anything in it. So I'm going to click on the dial pad again, and let's put some text in this column right here. I'll let go, and there is our text. And let's go ahead and put a video in the other column. So I will just go to the video element right here, drag and drop it right there. So now what I want to do first is let's go ahead and put our link to our video. So I'm going to click on the video here. And then right here we have our content options. I'm going to replace that URL with a different one that might be a little more appropriate for this video. And it's my Elementor review video. We have some options here for the video if I wanted it to autoplay, if I wanted to have the suggested videos, just various settings that we have specific to the video. They're all right there. Now, one of the nicest features of Elementor is most of the areas that have text, it has a feature called inline text editing. And what that means is I can just click and I can start editing my text visually. Now you always have this option here in the settings panel to start editing your text as well. So I'll go ahead and put a headline in here. Okay, we have a nice headline there, and I can choose my alignment right here, some of the properties of the text right here. Let's go ahead and change the color of the font. So I can go ahead and click in there, highlight it, and then we have these options here, and this will let me put bold or underline or italicize this. But what I want to do is change the color. So I'm going to click on style, and then here's my option for the text color. I'm going to go ahead and choose this white because that just works better for the background. I hope you're starting to see how easy it is to build a page on your WordPress website using Elementor. So next, let's take a look at some of their templates that come for free with Elementor. That was this option right here that says Add Template. Now, when you click on this, it's going to pull up the template library. I want to draw your attention to where it says Blocks, Pages, and My Templates. So blocks are these sections, but they're pre-designed, and you can easily just click on any of the pre-designed sections that you want. Now, they are organized by categories, and you have all these options here to choose from. You can even put a heart next to the ones that you like and favorite them. There is a wide variety of blocks for all kinds of different purposes right here. Adding a block to your website is very simple. You would just hover over it and there'll be an insert option. Click on that and it will download and be inserted right into your design. Building websites has never been this easy. Let's quickly take a look at some of the page templates that were available. I'll click on Add Template to pull that up, and I will click on Pages right here, and we can see a wide variety of page templates. Now, any of these thumbnail images that have a little Pro badge in the top right, those are for people that have Elementor Pro, which is an add-on to Elementor to give it additional modules and features that help you take your web design even further. And for any of these, you can simply find the template that you want and then click on Insert, and it will download and it will insert this into your page. And there you have it. It went ahead and inserted that design right here into my page. Now, before we go, I want to show you how to save sections so that you can reuse them later. So if you notice, I'm hovered over a section and we have this blue bar here at the top. These are our section settings panels. There's going to be this little floppy disk icon, and when you click on that, we get the option here to name this section we're about to save. I've named it my first save section, and then we can click on save, and it has now saved this section to the library so that I can use this over and over again on any page that I create using Elementor. And you can see it took us straight here to my templates. So now whenever you see the option here to add a template and you click on it and you click on my templates right there, you're going to see your various saved sections right there. Simply click on insert right here and that will be inserted into your page. Let's click on the X here to leave that menu. Now I want to show you how would you add content in between this section and this section. Whenever you hover over a section and you have your section options, there's this little plus. When you click on that, it will reveal the add new section and add template. So that's how you can later on add content in between existing sections. You can also move these sections around by hovering over to the leftmost icon, clicking, holding your mouse, and then dragging and then dropping that section wherever you'd like to reposition it on your page. So I'm going to go up to the top and remove these two sections that I created. I'm going to click on the X right there, click on the X right there, and they are now removed. I'm going to go ahead and click on the update button right here, and let's go ahead and preview this page. I'm going to click on the preview changes icon right there. It's going to open up into a new tab, and you can see we're already well on our way to having a beautifully designed website. So that is the full beginner's guide to using Elementor, the WordPress page builder. I'm going to have a link in the video description box to a playlist of tutorials that I have created that are here on YouTube covering Elementor, and you can work your way through those if you want to advance and further your training and understanding of Elementor so that you can build beautiful websites for yourself. Also, if you're new here, I should have introduced myself in the beginning. My name is Adam, and I'm from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress tutorials for non-techies. I try to make this stuff make sense. I hope you'd consider clicking on that subscribe button if you want more tutorials like this. There's also a little bell. When you click on that, YouTube will let you know when I have a new tutorial video. If you found any value in this video, I just want to ask you to give it a thumbs up. And if you have any questions, I'm more than happy to answer them for you in the comment section down below. I want to thank you for spending this time with me. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next Elementor tutorial video.